Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn 1.5. The children are going to school from My English Book 7. Before going to the poem, we will learn about the poet of this poem. What is the name of the poet? The name of the poet is Nida Fazli. Nida Fazli was born in 1938 and was died in 2016. Prominently, he has written his poem in Hindi and Urdu. Let's first understand the word prominently. What is mean by prominently? See, I will give you an example. My mother tongue is Marathi and prominently I speak in Marathi. And wherever it is needed, as per the situation, I use Hindi or English language. But prominently, I use Marathi language. I hope you understand the meaning of the prominently. Prominently means mukhyatve karun. Nida Fazli has written his poems, songs prominently in Hindi and Urdu. He has written different kinds of songs and poems. Also, he has written some dialogues. He was awarded by National Harmony Award and also he was awarded by the most prestigious award, and that is Padma Shri Award in 2016 for his contribution in English literature. Now in this poem, what poet said in this poem? In this poem, the poet has painted such a beautiful picture of morning scenery when the children are going to school. Now, let's proceed towards our poem. The children are going to school. Morning light spread over the earth. Once again, the sky bows his head in respect for the children are going to school. What is given here? Morning light spread. What is the time of the day it is? It is morning. And what happened in the morning? As we all know, that sun rises in the east. And what happened when the sun rises in the east? At that time, the darkness run away and the light spread all over the earth. That is what the poet is saying. Morning light spread all over the earth. And the once again, the sky bows his head in respect for the children are going to school. Now, what is the sky doing here? The sky is bowing his head. You might thought, how can it possible? Sky is an non-living thing. And how can a non-living thing behave like a person? See, dear children, one figure of speech is given here in these lines. As per your standard concern, figure of speech is not there directly introduced to your in your textbook. But I am just letting you know for your further standards that figure of speech introduced here is personification. What is the personification mean by in personification? An inhuman or non-living thing behave like a person, behave like a human being. And that is why we feel that sky is bowing his head in respect. As we all know, sky is a non-living thing. Sky can't do all those things. But poet is using his imagination. Poet is feeling that sky is bowing. Sky is bowing in respect for the children. For which children? Sky is bowing here for the children. Those are going to school. Now you might thought that why the sky is giving so much respect to the children? The sky is giving so much respect to the children just because they are going to school. Also, I think a thought came in your mind that going to school is a very regular, isn't any extraordinary thing in it. And why the sky is giving so much respect? See, going to school, though we find it's very regular, very casual, but it's very much important. Why? Because whenever we go to the school, we get knowledge, we become civilized, we develop ourselves. And if we develop ourselves, we can develop our state, our country. In this way, our country will be developed, and that is why going to school is very much important. And that is why the sky is bowing his head in respect. Now, let's proceed to our next stanza. The sun, after his morning dip in the river, dressed up in his golden muslin turban. Now, sun, what is the sun doing? Sun has taken a dip in the river. You might thought that geography teacher is telling sun is far away from the earth, and now this English teacher is telling that sun has taken a dip in the river. It's the imagination. It is not actual fact, but it's an imagination of the poet. Why the poet thinks so? Because whenever we saw the sun across the river, we feel that sun has came upon the river, and that is why the poet is saying the sun after his morning dip. Poet feels that sun has came after a dip, after his bath in the river, and now he is dressed up. See, when we take a bath, we wear our clothes in the same way. After getting fresh, sun has dressed up in his golden muslin turban. Let's understand some words first. Muslin. Muslin means what? Muslin means a soft cloth, a soft fabric. When we touch that fabric, we feel softness of that fabric. And that is what we call muslin. And turban, what is the mean by turban here? Turban is a head covering. In Marathi we say pagadi or feta. What sun is doing? See, try to understand. Sun, it has come from the other side of the river, and poet feels that sun has taken a dip in the river, and after taken the dip, he has dressed up, he has get ready with his golden muslin turban. And what is the sun doing next? Waits and smiles on one side of the road for children are going to school. Now sun is waiting here. And what is there on his face? The sun is smiling. Sun is happy. There is all smile on his face. Why sun is happy? Because sun is happy because the children are going to school and sun are waiting for them. In these lines also poet importance stressed the importance of the education. In the first stanza, what happened? Sky is bowing his head, and in this stanza, the sun is waiting and smiling for the children who are going to school. Now let's proceed to our next stanza. Through the green-topped branches, breezes sing their song of blessing. Now, where are these breezes? These breezes are on the green-topped branches. The breezes are on the top. They are not at the bottom. Try to understand the meaning, top. Breezes are on the top. And what are they doing from the top? They are singing the song of blessing. The breezes are singing. What kind of song are they singing? The song of blessing. Blessing means, in Marathi we say Ashirvad. Ashirvachanache Gayan. The breezes are singing the song of blessing. For whom? For the children who are going to school. Fragrant flowers awaken the sleepy roads with their melodies. Now it's turn of the fragrant flowers to welcome the children, to give the respect to the children. And what are these fragrant flowers are doing? They are awaking the sleepy road. You might thought, how could it possible? How can road sleep? Again, the personification figure of speech used here, that in the night time, what happened in the night time and early in the morning, not so much people on the road. We find a few people on the road, and compared to the daytime, at the daytime, lots of people we find on the road. In this way, poet thought that at the daytime, road is awakened. But in the night, road has become sleepy because not much people are there on the road. And now this sleepy road, who wake up the sleepy road? The fragrant flowers. And how are they going to wake the road up? They are going to wake up the road with their melody. Now, what is the mean by melodies? Melodies means a soft tune. See, dear children, one more thing I would like to tell you about, that when you, in the morning, when your mother used to wake you up, for the first time, mother wake you up with the melodies, isn't it? And if in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 calls you didn't get up, no, that melody turned into the tragedy. You have that experience, I know. Now, let's proceed to our next stanza. At the corner of the lane, the people in his lush deep foliage. Now, who is coming next? Now, it's peepal tree. And what is the peepal tree and where is he standing? The peepal tree is standing at the corner. And let's understand the meaning of this line. First, try to understand the meaning of this word, lush. Lush means what? Lush means thick. Lots of quantity is there. That is what it is called, lush. And foliage means what? Green leafy cover. Foliage means what? Green leafy cover. And try to understand the meaning of this line first. People in his lush deep foliage means the peepal tree, in simple word we will say, peepal tree which have lots of leaves. Get understand it? The peepal tree which have lots of leaves. And this peepal tree is standing at the corner. What is the peepal tree doing standing on the at the corner? The peepal tree waves his hands. As we all know, trees don't have hands. But poet imagine that the branches of the tree are tree's hands. And as the branches move, poet feels that trees are moving their hands. And that is why the poet is saying peepal tree is waving his hands. And for whom the tree is waving his hand? Again. Again, for the children who are going to the school. See what the sky is doing? Sky is bowing his head. What the sun is doing for the children? Sun has taken the dip in the river, get fresh, dressed up in a golden muslin turban, and waits and smiles for the children. And at the same time, breezes sing the song of blessing. Fragrant flowers are awake on the sleepy roads, and now this peepal tree is waving the hands in respect for the children, for those children who are going to school. Once again, the poet is pointing, noting the importance of the education. Now, let's proceed to our last stanza. Angels of light have set out. Every road is gleam. See, it's the morning time, and as we all know, in the morning time, sun rises from the east. And as the sun rises, The sun rays are spread all over the earth. And when the poet saw that light spread all over the earth, poet feels that those are the angels of light. Now, what is the meaning of angels here? Angels means dut. Now, these dut have came on the earth and they are spreading the light. And what happened when the angels spreading the light? Every road is a gleam. Let's understand the word gleam first. Gleam means what? Glittering. In other word, in Marathi we will say chamakne. Now what happened? Because of the light, because of the sun rays, every road is glittering. Every road is gleam. See dear children, poet wanted to tell you one more thing here. What is that thing? That education is a form of light. Whoever get the education, the darkness from his soul came out. And the person who get the education also gleam, also glitter with the help of the education he gets. That is what poet wanted to stress. Now, what happened at this hour? At this hour, every particle of the earth throbs like mother's heart. See, what mother's heart do? Mother's heart throbs. Throbs means what? Beat. Why the mother's heart is beating? The mother's heart is beating for the goodness, for the wellness of the child. Each and every mother want her child should get good education and should become a person, a civilized person. And now, who is throbbing like mother's heart? Every particle of the earth. Not only sun, not only sky, not only the breezes, not only the people, tree. Now, each and every particle around us throbbing like the mother's heart. And why it is throbbing? Every particle on the earth want that the child, that the children should get the education and should become a civilized person. Time sitting on an old roof. Now see, what is the time doing? Time is sitting. Where is the time sitting? The time is sitting on an old roof. And what is the time doing or sitting on that old roof? The time is flying the pigeons in the sky. What is the time doing? Time is flying the pigeons in the sky. Why pigeons? Just think about it. Why pigeons only? Why not other birds? Think about it. I will explain. Pigeons are stand for the peace. And the person who gets education always become the peaceful. He doesn't do anything which is violent. And that is why the time sitting on an old roof flies the pigeon. For whom? For the children are going to school. All these things are doing for whom? For the children are going to school. I hope you understand the poem. Now I am going to summarize the poem in short. What poet is saying in this poem? The sky is bowing his head, the sun after his dip in the river, and dressed up in golden muslin turban, the breezes are singing the song of blessing, on the green topped branches, people tree waving his hand, all the particles on the earth throbs like mother's heart, time is sitting on an old roof, and flying the pigeon. Why all these things are doing all those activities? Just for the children for those children who are going to school. In this way, in this poem, the poet is stressing the importance of the education. In this COVID period, what happened? We can't go to our school. But even though I request to all my dear pupils, to all my dear kiddos, just be in touch of the education. Don't leave the education, because education itself a power. And so get that power and be powerful. Thank you. Now it's time to do the homework. And your homework is solve English workshop on page number 25.